Retired Colonel Charles Okello Engola, who has been the State Minister for Labour, Employment and Industry Relations, was shot dead at his home today morning by his UPDF military guard at his residence in Chanja, a Kampala suburb. The UPDF bodyguard, after killing the late Engola, went on a shooting spree, shouting out his grievances. The bodyguard, Private Wilson Sabiti, also shot his fellow UPDF guard before he walked to a nearby saloon and shot himself dead. Addressing journalists today at the weekly press conference held at the police headquarters in Naguru, the police spokesperson Fred Enanga confirmed the shooting and sent his condolences to the bereaved family, the president, the cabinet, the people of Langosa region and Ugandans.
He fled from the scene up to the trading center at Chanja Ring Road, where he entered the saloon and also shot himself dead. The Deputy Inspector General of Police, together with the Director CID, have responded to this incident. The investigation is currently in the early stages of review.
Whereas eyewitnesses said the soldier was yelling that he had not received his monthly salary for several months, police say they have kicked off an investigation to ascertain the motive behind the murder. According to police, a team of detectives have been deployed and have combed the entire place for exhibits and also interviewing witnesses.
We've also dispatched a team of crime scene experts who are using the most advanced forensic technology to get what exactly was the cause of this tragic murder.
But for now, this is the information we can give you, that we confirm that the minister is dead, and the Private Sabit is also dead, the person who shot, and then the ADC or team, Ronald, sustained severe injuries, but he's being treated in Marago Hospital.
The police spokesperson also confirmed that the killer bodyguard also injured the minister's aide-de-camp, Lieutenant Ronald Otim. The UPDF deputy spokesperson, Lieutenant Deo Akik, explains that they hope to get more information from Lieutenant Ronald Otim once he recovers.
So this soldier had been changed from Bombo to come here, then even here he had been changed from being now in the principal car, from being actually in the principal car to the leading car. So we can't at the moment tell exactly what could have caused him behaving this way. I'm sure if he was alive, we would have taken him for a mental checkup. But unfortunately, he killed himself.
Akik eulogized the late retired Colonel Charles Engola as a dedicated soldier who fought to ensure that the country received the much-desired liberation.
We worked with him in the operations against LRA in Zambia Battalion. He comes to other ministers, so he's someone who has interacted with almost each of us, either as a civilian or as a soldier. So it is unbelievable that this soldier could have taken such an act.
The deceased minister last made a public appearance during the International Labour Day celebrations in Namutumba District yesterday. Report compiled by Rachel Nachuala for the news.